are excited to celebrate the centennial of our alma mater, the Academy of Notre Dame. These are some pictorial glimpses into the birth, growth, and demise of our beloved school. An essential component of the Academy experiences is the School Sisters of Notre Dame. This religious order was founded in Bavaria in 1833. Mother Mary Teresa of Jesus was the foundress of the order. In 1847, missionaries in North America requested the SSND to send teachers to teach children of immigrants. In 1859, Belleville, Illinois became a destination of service. Sister Mary Jerome and two others arrived and established the Institute of the Immaculate Conception, a boarding school for girls. On the night of January 5th, 1884, a devastating fire destroyed the school, and Mother Jerome and three other sisters, as well as 22 students, perished. A memorial statue was erected at Greenmount Catholic Cemetery to commemorate the 26 that died. The four sisters are buried there. The Institute was rebuilt at the same location, 3rd and Harrison, most recently the site of St. Elizabeth's Hospital Emergency Department, now a vacant lot. In 1924, the decision was made to expand and relocate the secondary school for girls to 6401 West Main Street. It was renamed the Academy of Notre Dame. The first building constructed on the expansive campus was Annunciation Hall. Construction continued alongside education during those first few months. In early December, the chapel was completed. The memorial tower bell was transferred to the new building. On Christmas Eve, 1925, it rang for the first time at the Academy of Notre Dame. It was inscribed with the names of those who died in the 1884 fire, another link with educational heritage of the SSND in Belleville. By 1928, the school already needed more room, but financial limits and the Great Depression made expansion impossible. Finally, on September 11, 1938, the three-story visitation hall was dedicated. It was built to accommodate 500 students. The final addition to the campus came in 1964. Regina Hall was a combination gymnasium and cafeteria. It had been learned that the land beneath the campus was subsiding due to underground mine shafts. The construction was built with this in mind. The older buildings were not so fortunate. Visitation Hall first showed evidence of subsidence damage. It was determined it could not be salvaged and it had to be raised. In 1968, mobile units provided temporary relief. They housed freshman homerooms and classroom space to assist with needs resulting from the loss of Visitation Hall. faced with worsening prospects for further structural damage, the SSND decided that the Academy of Notre Dame would need to close. In December 1971, the remaining 497 students gathered in the gym to be told that the Academy of Notre Dame would close at the end of the school year. On May 19, 1972, 114 graduates were the last to receive their diplomas from the Academy of Notre Dame, ending a 113-year unbroken line beginning with the first graduate of Immaculate Conception. The emotional response of the Academy students was summarized in an article in the final edition of the Readaway in May 1972. And now we will put away the chairs. How many times has this phrase been uttered after an assembly? That sentence was just as much a part of Notre Dame as our assemblies were, and as much a part of Notre Dame as we were. All those times are gone now. Life at Notre Dame has come to an end. And now we will put away the chairs forever. Most remaining students transferred to Altoff Catholic High School, which is the co-ed facility opened in September 1964, replacing the former Cathedral Boys High School. A few of the historical artifacts survive. The Angelus Bell was shipped to a church in Ghana. The Fatima Grotto found its home at St. Henry's Church. And the chapel altar and the stained glass from the chapel occupy Mary's altar area in the Cathedral of St. Peter. Heritage Hall at Altoff Catholic High School also maintains a display of memorabilia from the Academy of Notre Dame, as well as the other former Catholic high schools, Cathedral High School, Assumption High School, and St. Teresa's Academy. Regina Hall is the only original academy building remaining. It housed medical offices for many years, but is currently vacant and is for sale. The site of the other campus buildings has been replaced with a shopping center and restaurants.
Seem to go, but you don't know what you've got till it's gone. They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. They paved paradise, put up a parking lot.
Although the brick and mortar edifice of our memories is gone, it will never be forgotten. The legacy of the Academy of Notre Dame will survive through the lives and relationships of all those who passed through its halls.